Hello everyone, and welcome to this introductory tutorial on the SOLIDWORKS user interface. I won't be covering any real usage of any SOLIDWORKS tools, only the basics of the interface and how to navigate around it to have some baseline to work off of. This has been reset to standard. This is roughly what you'll see when you install a copy of SOLIDWORKS Student 2020-2021. This pop-up menu here, I'm going to use it to create a part. This is, by default, what you will see when creating a new part. So you'll notice that the sidebar there disappears immediately when you click out of it. That's good. That sidebar can be ignored for now. You'll have, by default, this large center view, which is the viewport that shows the part you're working on. This sidebar on the left, which has multiple tabs, the most important of which is this one, the feature manager, that shows all the features of the part you're working on, or if it were an assembly, all its parts, and then below them, their features. Or if it were a drawing, all of its sheets, and below them, the views on the sheets. You have this toolbar at the top that's split into tabs for different tasks, features, sketch, markup, evaluate. Most of the time you'll be spending in features, sketch, and evaluate. And you have a hidden menu bar near the SOLIDWORKS logo. If you hover over that arrow, it'll show up and you should pin it because you'll use it fairly often, especially to save parts and so on. The last critical component for basic use of SOLIDWORKS is in the bottom right here, where it says, for me, MMGS. If I click on that, that is the unit switcher. I can use it to switch between millimeters, grams, seconds, and inch, pound, second. When you're doing a part, it's important to know which unit you're working in or which unit system you're working in so that you make it to proper scale. Now, basic navigation of this interface. I am going to make the three planes visible so that I have something to rotate and pan around. So by default, you'll be looking at a trimetric view of the part. You can switch between all of the standard projections using this view orientation cube at the top of the viewport. So if I click it, it'll give me the option of top, front, bottom, left, right, back, so on. It'll also give me isometric, and in the arrow beside isometric, diametric and trimetric, which is the default selected. I'm going to click isometric. I can rotate freeform around the part by holding the middle mouse button and dragging the mouse. That'll allow me to rotate. I can pan by holding down Control and doing the same, and I can zoom by holding down Shift and doing the same. Now, if you don't have a mouse, you're using a touchpad, and therefore you don't have a middle mouse button, I recommend using a mouse. It's really much easier to work with. But in the view menu of the menu bar up here, you can go to modify and you can access rotate, pan, zoom in, zoom out, so on and so forth. Those are all the basic parts of the user interface. You can return to a standard zoom that shows everything by clicking zoom to fit at the top of the viewport. And once again, you can return to isometric using this little view cube at the top of the viewport. That covers everything about the basics of the user interface. Next video, I'll start on how to create a part using SOLIDWORKS.